like she might be lactating, so I'm wondering if she's not... doesn't look especially pregnant. She's not a very big giraffe, as giraffe go. She's not very tall. Texan, if you're interested, there's a Dlamiti on the junction of Zoe's and Philemon's cut line. Sure, she's not going anywhere.
Thank you.
Sorry madam, just had to pick something up off the road.
And also this morning when I came back, I saw the photo for Madoda Ngala at Western South Crown of Manyeleshi. But it looks like they went inside Manyeleshi. I don't know, maybe they'll come out this afternoon.
A piece of tortoise that I just picked up off the road.
There was a report of the guys who saw one of Kurula's Matipas on Central. So somewhere just this area.
I wonder if it's not maybe a hyena that dropped it here. It's got a couple of teeth marks in it. Just a piece of tortoise. Relatively fresh. Interestingly about giraffe is the fact that their blood pressure is probably one of the highest of any of the mammals. Exceptionally thick-walled heart to produce that kind of blood pressure. And amazing adaptations too, in that it has this blood pressure, this incredible heart to be able to get blood up to the brain. But by the same token, it's got to deal with that high blood pressure below the heart, of course, because of gravity. And when one thinks of the legs, one would think that the veins would have to be so much thicker, harder, to be able to deal with it. And in actual fact, it's actually a combination of things. They have a broader network of veins, but they also have very, very thick skin. And it is very, very tight over the legs, over the bones. In fact, if you look at their front legs, there's very little meat around those bones. It's sort of skin stretched over bone. And that is to help deal with that kind of a phenomenon. Various veins, or rather various valves in the main blood vessels heading up to the brain that help regulate the blood pressure when they put their heads down, either to pick things up off the ground or when they're drinking, so as not to overload the brain. family of oxbeckers arguing over right to grooming her. Sounds like our radio's not working, so it's possible I'm not getting any questions because of that. Unfortunately, it's going to be one of those drives. I'll have to get back and maybe try and answer questions when I get back a little bit later. Big bolus of food that she's chewing. You might even watch it go down when she swallows, and then she'll see how she brings up another one. You can actually follow it going down the neck. Ruminants, as are most of the herbivores here, the two-toed ungulates, should I say. Alright, so there's some young oxbeckers on her that are being fed by their parents. Soliciting food.
Good afternoon, Juno Radar Station, Johnny Mobile. Any update?
Yeah, Johnny, no update, but I just running just still 1 second and 10 days.
Okay, nothing on Madurai Radar.
Hello, John, I just put a couple of rent to the north from the western side of Manila to come.
Okay, stop, buddy. I'm going to be coming to
Greg, you got my camera with you? Yeah, affirmative.
Yeah,
no problem. Or otherwise, if Jess comes over, maybe she can bring it back. Silly me. Let's see if we can move again. I'd like to spend some time with her. You know, we don't have giraffe here that often. We haven't had for a while. Be nice to spend some time with her. Wow, I wonder if this is going to hit us. Coming from behind, actually. Normally we get our rain from the south or the southeast. At the moment, we've got a huge black cloud that I was showing earlier up in the north, heading our way. There we go.
Hi everyone, this is Kaz in Final Control with an echo. It looks like they've lost their signal now. I will get in touch with them and let them know the situation, and they'll be back with you as soon as they get it back, which is a real shame because it's really nice to see this giraffe. I hope we can fix it. I am very hot today. It's a lovely day here, Juma. Peter Bratt is actually on his way to have a look at the dam cam sound, see if there's anything he can do about it. So hopefully that will get up and running very soon. Also, just want to remind you that at Fireside Chat tonight, Herman and Patrick are going to be doing Jess's banana soup, but they've got a bit frightened about making it. So, because Jess is working, Herman's actually making a video now on how to make the soup so everyone can follow along at home. And then they're going to have it and talk about it and how easy it is to make, etc. And we're all going to taste it live on air. So I'm looking forward to that. That's going to be my dinner for tonight. And those of you who want to join along with cooking, that would be really great if you could. We're very excited to make the soup. It sounds very interesting and very tasty. I believe some people have tried it already. So, yeah, all good. My signal's not coming back. I'm going to see what else I can find around Gari. There were some Impala here a few minutes ago, but they seem to have walked off to Pastures Green. So I'll have a pan around, and we might even see Peter down there just now. Some of you are asking where the recipe is for it. The recipe is on my Facebook page, and it's also on my fan page. And some people were going to post it, but I don't know where it has been put. But if you go to my Facebook page, the recipe is there in the notes, and you can get the ingredients. I don't know how else to put it up because I'm not very technical. It's a bit higher grade for me. I put the recipe up probably about a week ago now, or maybe 4 days, so it has been up for a while. Sorry if you couldn't find it, I don't know how to make it very obvious for everyone, so I thought if I put it on my page and wrote some notes about it, people would find it. I've lost picture. I think we possibly need to move on or move the vehicle.
It's actually moving southeast. I don't know if it's going to get to us. But it's going to join up with that big storm over there. That's
lucky to actually watch her because she's making her way down towards Gowrie Main, so she could well cross over. She's gone from us a few days again. Sorry, madam.
Sounds
not
like
forcing you on at all. Actually tracks of another giraffe here. I think there's a Baker running. I don't know if it could be her. But the tracks crossing the road from her side coming over this way. Also leopard tracks here. Hello, pretty girl. Quite remarkable how they walk with the legs on the same side. No, they don't topple over. Thank you, Mrs. G. We'll be moving along now.